सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतं अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीं अम्बत्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवत् गीते भवद्वेषिणी। यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्र रुद्र मरुतः सुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः यस्यां तं न विदुःसुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः। श्लोक नंबर 39। अथ द्वितीयोऽध्यायः। श्रीभगवानुवाच एषा ते विहिता सांख्ये बुद्धिर्योगेऽपि मां शृणु बुद्ध्या युक्तो यया पार्थ कर्मबन्धं प्रहास्यसि नेहाभिक्रमनाशोऽस्ति प्रत्यवायो न विद्यते स्वल्पमप्यस्य धर्मस्य त्रायते महतो भयात् व्यवसायात्मिका बुद्धिः एकेह कुरुनन्दन बहुशाखाह्यनन्ताश्च बुद्धयो व्यवसायिनां। In the 39th shloka, Bhagavan formally concluded the topic of Sankhya Yoga, the topic of self-knowledge, and he introduced the topic of Karma Yoga. Not as an alternative means, it is not that if Jnana Yoga doesn't work, you try Karma Yoga. If Karma Yoga doesn't work, try Bhakti Yoga. If Bhakti Yoga doesn't work, you try Hatha Yoga. You try some Nada Yoga. If they are not the options for moksha. But if Jnana Yoga is found to be difficult by you, then prepare yourself by Karma Yoga. It is a preparatory means and not an alternative means. And Bhagavan glorified this Karma Yoga, saying that if you have this understanding of Karma Yoga and you follow it, then finally you will attain freedom from all types of bondage. So that is called prarochanaya, for motivating the person, the glorification is done. In any pursuit, motivation is important. If you are not motivated, even though you start something, but not fully motivated, then he will not continue. Arambha shuraha hi kalu dakshinatyaha. For South Indians and North Indians have said perhaps that South Indians are very good in starting, but they don't maintain. Actually, it's not that only South Indians. Sarve janaha. So all people are like this. See, you see, 1st January comes, you know, you must have done New Year resolutions. I will write diary every day, and new diary you buy, 100 rupees, 200 rupees, very big diary, and first day, second day, third day you have written, then empty. Nothing is there. Again next year, like that you will have so many diaries. Why? Arambha shura kalu dakshinat. In fact, the gym people also, they know this, that in the January, February, there is a lot of rush in gym. They raise perhaps their, I think, subscription, they make a raise. But more people will join, no? New Year resolution. So one has to have sufficient motivation for sustaining the pursuit. And motivation, in Sanskrit called prerana, this motivation comes from understanding the significance of the goal. Understanding the significance of the means, how it helps. If you understand very well and you are convinced of the significance of the means and the goal, then you will have commitment to the means and the goal. So in any pursuit of life, if you want your pursuit to be successful, you should have motivation. And for having motivation, you should be convinced of the significance of the goal and the means for that goal. And therefore, Bhagavan Sri Krishna praised this Karma Yoga. And he continued to praise. In the 40th sloka also he said, this Karma Yoga doesn't have the problems which are there in Kamya Karma. Kamya Karma means this karmas done without Karma Yoga attitude. Karma done only for materialistic desire, that is called Kamya Karma. And in Kamya Karma, there are various problems, issues, which are not there in Karma Yoga. That was in the 40th sloka. And in the 41st sloka, it is said, in Karma Yoga, person has got well-ascertained thinking with conviction. So in the thinking of the Karma Yogi, there is clarity and conviction. And when you have got clarity and conviction, you remain on the track and you keep on growing. For growth, you require clarity and conviction of the means and ends. And Karma Yogi has this. Karma Yogi knows that I am following the sadhana of Karma Yoga, which will prepare me for self-knowledge. And the self-knowledge is by Shravana Manana Nididhyasanam. And by that I will get self-knowledge, which is the means for moksha. Path is very clear. And when you have got clarity and conviction about the path, then you will not have wastage of resources, wastage of time. If you are confused about the path, whether this is the right path or not, then what will happen? You do some for some time, again you come back. You walk on that path, again come back. Or stop walking. And you say, now another path, another path. Many people, they have this habit. They start one text, study for some time, drop it. No, it's because maja nahi aaya. So another text, another text, another text. They don't complete any text. Always waiting. Samadhi, when will you start this text? Hey, whatever text you started, did you complete? No. So in life, there should be consistency. Means some focused approach. And that is there when you have got this clarity and conviction. Clarity and conviction gives you focus. The people who do not have clarity and conviction about the means and the end, they don't have focused approach. One Swamiji used to give the example. It is something like you want water from the ground. So you dig for 10 feet. वाटर नहीं आया डिड कम अनदर प्लेस यू डिग 10 फिट अनदर प्लेस यू डिग 10 फिट एंड यू हैव डग 20 प्लेसेस 10 फिट विल यू गेट वाटर नो बिकॉज वाटर इज एट 80 फिट इफ यू हैड डग इन वन प्लेस यू वुड हैव गॉट वाटर much before this your exercise of digging in 20 places is completed but you dug what you did in one place you did not dig the bond is changing doesn't happen. So karma yogi has got the focused approach because he has got clarity and conviction. I feel that most of the people have not understood the importance of clarity and conviction. That is why they are confused. In fact, their face itself like looks like a question mark face, you know, who all the time, what? Confused. Confusion personified. So, that's what happens. And therefore, in Karma Yoga, Bhagavan says, Vyavasayatmika Buddhi. Well-ascertained thinking. And well-ascertained thinking indicates clarity and conviction. For this eka iha, iha means in this pursuit of moksha, which is consisting of karma yoga and sankhya yoga. And it is based on the pramanam, and you have shraddha in pramanam, and therefore you will be having focused approach. Whereas avyavasayinam, the people who are not blessed with this clarity and conviction, they will have the thinking having many branches and innumerable subdivisions. Bahushaka, regarding the sadhyam itself, there are so many options. And for every sadhya, for every goal, again there are so many options in terms of means. So bahushaka means sadhya bahulyam and ananta means sadhana bahulyam. Bahulyam means manyness. And therefore, these people will have multifarious thinking. So you ask him, every time you ask, he will say, new project. What are you doing? Oh, I am doing this business. And after some time, what happened? Oh, business did not work. So I am doing a job. And next time again, you ask, he will say something. I am doing business and job. So, and next time you go, what are you doing? Nothing. Neither business. That is the condition of the person. I have seen some people, keep on changing. Yeah, if there is a solid, justifiable reason and therefore you change, it is healthy. It is not that you should be stuck. Just you have chosen one, therefore. But you should give up something, you should renounce something with a solid reason and after sufficient deliberation. Otherwise, if you keep on changing, you will not attain. As Pujya Swamiji, I referred last class, when you don't have infinity as the goal, you will have infinite goals. Means, if Paramatma Prapti is not your goal, then you will have so many goals because you want fulfillment in your life. Everybody wants fulfillment in life. In fact, you are doing whatever you are doing is for that only. Everybody wants fulfillment, fullness in life. And that fullness is Paramatma, Brahman. So even though you may not say that I want Brahman, but what really you want is Brahman only. Knowingly or unknowingly, everybody is seeking Brahman. Whether he is atheist or theist, whatever he is, she is, everybody wants this fullness, which is Brahman. And person doesn't know what is the right means. And if you do not know the right means and still you have the desire for the goal, what will you do? You will adopt the wrong means. And therefore what will happen? You will be spending your energy on so many wrong means. And wrong means will not work. Therefore you try the first wrong means, did work, second, third, fourth. Keep on changing. In a modern time, it is more. People immediately change. A little bit of a sofa, they want to change this sofa cover. They want to change the sofa pattern. They like to change. They are not happy with what is. Keep on changing. Job, they are changing. place they are changing. Now wife also changing and husband both. They are also changing. You see, divorce rate is so much increased. Hey, that also after so many, like nowadays another trend is that after engagement minimum gap of 1 year. Yesterday somebody was telling, said that this much. I said, why? He said they have to know each other and all. I said, if they know each other, they will not marry. Ignorance is bliss sometimes. Anyway, so perhaps it is required, because she was telling me, I get all my stuff from this discussion only. See, because nowadays so many people meet on marriage bureau and website and all this. That's why they have to know each other. And so on, I told, I have no problem, you do that. But keep on changing. And why is it so? Because the clarity is not there. What is the right means for purnatvam, fullness I am seeking in my life? And that was said here, bahushakha hyanantasya buddhayo vyavasayinam. And now, in the next three shlokas, those people who are committed to bhoga, who are committed to this power and bhoga, what is their life? And to such people, this well-ascertained conviction does not come. That is said in the next three shlokas. So we'll read three shlokas.
Yamimam pushpitam vacham pravadantya vipashchitaha vedavadaratah partha nanyadastiti vadinaha kamatmanasvargaparaha जन्मकर्मफलप्रदाम् क्रियाविशेषबहुलाम् भोगैश्वर्यगतिं प्रति भोगैश्वर्यप्रसक्तानां तया पहृतचेतसाम् व्यवसायात्मिका बुद्धिः समाधौ न विधीयते.
You may be wondering, Swami, why three shlokas you read together? One shloka we generally do. Because grammatically, these three shlokas make one sentence. And therefore we read them together. The content of this shloka is that vyavasayatmika buddhi, well ascertained conviction regarding karma yoga and jnana yoga, does not take place in the mind of certain people. This understanding of karma yoga and commitment to follow this life of karma yoga, and later on understanding this jnana yoga, lifestyle of jnana yoga, the content of jnana yoga, that doesn't happen with everybody. If karma yoga is so great, why everybody is not following? If jnana yoga is so great, why everybody is not following? That question may come. And that is answered here, that this vyavasayatmika buddhi, that well ascertained conviction regarding the means and the ends, na vidhiyate. Last line, vyavasayatmika buddhi, well ascertained thinking, na vidhiyate, does not take place. Where? Samadhau. Here samadhi has got the meaning, the mind. Samyak adhiyate, it is samadhi, mind here. It's not that in samadhi it doesn't take place. So samadhi here means mind. Bhagavan Sri Krishna is mischievous, so he uses some words, you know. Samadhi means here mind. So vyavasayatmika buddhihi, well ascertained thinking, na vidhiyate, does not take place in the mind of certain people. Who are those people? That is described in the 44th shloka. We have to go back and forth here. So, who are those people? Bhogeshvarya Prasaktanam. Prasaktanam means highly attached. The people who are highly attached to bhoga, pleasure, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha, in terms of sound, touch, taste. So, all bhogas. And Aishwarya. Aishwarya means power. Prasaktana. The people who are attached to that, I want more and more bhoga. Some people, they have to have so many bhogas to keep them little bit good humor. Keep on eating. There is no gap. The lunch, between lunch and breakfast and lunch, there is no gap. Keep on, in Hindi, the chakki chalu hai. So, that chakki means that, floor meal is for chakki. So, he continues. Bhoga. See, some people are like this. As, by the way, that is called sometimes emotional eating. Emotional eating means what? It is not that you are hungry and therefore you are eating. You are feeling depressed. You are feeling low. And therefore, you keep on eating something to feel good. Sometimes you eat some chocolate. It gives some serotonin or something, So your mind has got some feeling of pleasure. And that's why in olden days, this by the way, in olden days when people were worried or some situation comes, people used to become thin, when they are worried. So we say he is worried, therefore become thin. Nowadays opposite. When people are worried, they become fat. Because worried and they find out the way, what? They eat some chocolate and all this junk food. Night, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, Yanisha Sarva Bhutana. Yanisha Sarva Bhutana means that in the Bhagavad Gita is going to come. That wise people, they remain awake at night. And this ignorant people, they sleep at night, whereas these wise people remain awake. It's a different meaning, but that's what happens. So, bhoga. Keep on eating. Similarly, other bhogas. Some people have this sparsha bhoga, some people have rasa bhoga, prasaktana. So, he uses the word prasakta, means highly attached, highly passionate about all bhogas. You see, when any... some foreign singers come. So what they call the singers? That is from abroad, some people come, playback or some party, they come. And my God, they have to have huge ground. In Bangalore, there is a palace ground they have to have. From, I don't even understand what they are singing. In fact, they are not singing, they are doing music, not singing music. So much. In Goa and all this year end, my God, huge parties. If he asks for Bhagavad Gita class, hardly few people come. Parties there. How people get time? Otherwise, most of the people say, no time. The cricket match, how much time is there? People have time. That's why they keep this IPL final always Gujarat, that big stadium. Why? Because it's the maximum capacity it has. I think the biggest in the world, perhaps, cricket stadium. Why? So many people will come. Bhoga prasaktanam, highly attached. Aishwarya, power. How much attached many people to get power, to become a minister, how much they have to do. They feel so much resentment if they don't get ticket or they don't get the berth in the cabinet. Prasaktanam. And it is not that only they have power, hunger. In family also, you want power. You want to be the main person of the family. You should be listened to by others. Swamiji, nobody listens to you in my family. One person was telling, Swamiji, in my house, nobody listens to me. So, power, I want power. People should listen to me, controlled by me. There is a big need to control others. It's a psychological issue. Why I want to control? Because I have got insecurity. When there is sense of insecurity, you want to control. And you want to control it at the family level, at the society level. In society, people should listen to me. And at the government level. So, bhogeshvariya prasaptanam. To such people, this karma yoga, sankhya yoga, buddhi cannot occur. You go and talk to some politician. He said, I will talk to you karma yoga and all. He said something, Swamiji. In my mind, this is happening. So next election, how will I get ticket or not? That is there in the mind. And what karma yoga, jnana yoga will occur to them? Nothing. Nothing goes inside. So bhogeshvariya prasaktanam vyavasayatmika buddhihi na vidhiyate. And another adjective for such people, taya aparuta chetasa. The people whose mind is aparuta, kidnapped, overpowered by that. And that refers to the words of the people who are committed to karma and karma phala. So taya, it is an adjective for vacham, the words. So some people are highly influenced by the words of those people who are always glorifying the materialistic achievement and materialistic pursuit. And those people whose words are influencing these people, they are described in the first two slokas. And who are they? Avipashitaha. Avipashita means alpamedasaha. So people who are committed to karma kanda, they are described here. They have got some buddhi. That is why they are going to at least Vedas. But in Vedas, there are two parts. Karma kanda and jnana kanda. And these people are focused on only karma kanda. And therefore, they are called alpa medasaha, avipashitaha. Vipashita means intelligent. Avipashitaha means less intelligent. We don't call them non-intelligent. Some intelligence they have, because of which they are following Vedas. So they are better than those who do not have Shraddha at all in Shastras. But their intelligence is not going beyond Karma Kanda. And therefore, Avipashitaha, less intelligent, they Vedavada Rataha. Rataha means passionately engaged. Vedavada, in the words of Vedas, which are talking about various karma and karma phala. If you do this ritual, you will get this loka. If you do this ritual, you will have this power. If you do this ritual, you will have this pleasure. So these are called Vedavada. These type of statements which are talking about karma and karma phala. And these people are Rataha, passionately engaged. Not simply engaged. Vedavada Rataha, passionately engaged in the sentences of Vedas, which are talking about various actions and their results. And Na Anyad Asti Iti Vadinaha. They are so confident about what they are doing. And they say, Na Anyad Asti. Other than the karma and karma phala, there is no other pursuit in life. Iti vadinaha. In this manner, they are telling. See, you may be having certain stage of evolution, certain stage of growth. That is all right. You may not be at the highest rung of the ladder. But at least you have got this awareness that I still need to grow. That humility needs to be there. Whereas these people are saying, this alone is ultimate. Karma and karma phala alone is everything. That alone is the message of Vedas. Nothing else can be gained from Vedas. And therefore their mind is not open. Some people are confused, but still they can be enlightened if they are aware that they are confused. If they are confused but they know that they are confused, we can help them. But some people are confused and they think that they alone are clear, all are confused. like in the mental hospital, these all the inmates, they are thinking, we 20 people who are staying here, we alone are sane. Only every day morning these two fellows come, they are insane. So they think that they alone are sane, others are insane. Similarly, these people, they are confused and they think that they alone are clear, all are confused. And that creates a block in coming out of confusion. Therefore, in life, let us have humility to accept this fact that I can go wrong. That humility is there, and if somebody corrects, at least you will pay attention. Some people, they are so confident and wrongly confident. And if you tell them, not ready to listen. We cannot help them. We have to pray for them. For such people, we can't help directly. We pray to Bhagwan, oh Lord, let him have some openness in mind so that one day he will seek help. Some people have difficulty in seeking help. Which is Swamiji's statement, I always repeat, that it is intelligent to seek help when you need help. Ask for help. Some people think that asking for help is a sign of weakness. No, it is an intelligent. If I don't know, then we ask him. Even the worker we ask, I say, how it is to be done? In fact, I see they have got more intelligence than me in so many areas. They have got some practical ways, they will say. So most of the time I ask them, what is the solution? You know, they can suggest because they are in that field. No, we are Swami, and so why should we ask? Is it idiocy? Ask. When they have worked in that field, they will have. Perhaps we can correct or we can suggest something. That's a different thing. But at least they may have some starting point can be them. So these people are so confident, overconfident in the wrong thinking. And therefore they say, na anyad asti iti vadina. Karma and karma phala alone is the ultimate pursuit in life. Nothing else is there. And kamatmanaha. They are embodiment of kama. Means they are full of so many desires. I want this, 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 I want this. And nowadays it is considered good. Person is very ambitious. Yes. Up to a point, ambition is required in life to come out of tamoguna. In fact, we encourage. Shastra also encourages people. Initially, Shastra talks about kamya karma so that person comes out of tamoguna. Tamoguna means this laziness, lethargy. From tamoguna, lethargy, laziness, you cannot go to sattvaguna directly. You have to first from tamoguna, you have to go to rajoguna. And rajoguna means what? Desires and activities. And Shastra's approach is that help the person from where he or she is. You cannot make the person jump too high. Suppose a person is very lazy, most of the time feeling sleepy, and I will say, you please come, I will conduct meditation for you. He says, I am doing meditation all the time. And therefore, to such people, it is not there. See, earlier in yoga ashram, for everything, they used to conduct this meditation and all this. So even for this depression, people with depression say that we conduct meditation. Now they have changed the approach. He said, no, for person who have got lot of depression, too much meditation is not good. For them, lot of this exercise, dynamic exercise, that is required. Depression is a characteristic of tamoguna. And so from tamoguna, person has to come out by resorting to rajoguna. Rajoguna is expressed in the form of activities and desires. Therefore, in initial stage, we do say, have desire, have ambitions, so that you don't remain in tamoguna. But after a certain stage in life, one has to outgrow. Whereas these people, till the end of their life, kamat panaha, embodiment of kamas, full of this binding desires. Swarga paraha, committed to heaven, heaven bound people. Some people don't say, I am not heaven bound. You may not be heaven bound, but US bound, you know, or Australia bound, or UK bound, Switzerland bound. So, I am not happy where I am. I want to go to some different place. Nowadays, they have this report that many millionaires are leaving India. This is a big concern now for India. Or many rich people, some 6,500 millionaires or billionaires, they left India. Because India is no good. So, we always want some different setup. Thinking that setup will change me. Setup alone will make me full and complete. So these people are thinking that local people, local setup is not good enough to make me happy. So I will go to heaven. And in Shastra there is a description. Heaven, there are apsaras are there, dance is there, music is there, and amruta rasa, something like wine is there. And you know, in heaven, one great thing is, if you don't drink, you don't feel thirsty. But at the same time, you can drink. So, you don't have hunger and thirst. Otherwise, a problem. Morning we have to eat, afternoon we have to eat, evening we have to eat. One Mahatma was telling after eating, he said, well, kab tak khana padega? So, how long we have to eat, you know? We have been eating for how many years? As many years old you are. So, kab tak khana padega? But in heaven, if you don't eat, no problem. But if you want to eat, you can eat. What a nice, elastic stomach. So much description is there. In Katopdeshad also, na tatra tvam na jaraya bibheti. You will remain sweet 16 forever. So, all the time you are young. No disease comes, COVID, etc. problem is not there. Now we have forgotten by God's grace. Otherwise, COVID is to be our example most of the time. So, heaven, so swarga paraha. So, these people are heaven bound. In fact, most of the religions are heaven bound only. You ask them, if I do all what you are saying, like in other religion, if you ask, if you do what all I, whatever you are saying, if I do, what will I get? You will go to heaven. And in heaven, they have got description little different. In Christianity, say, in heaven, you will dine with God. Pujya Swamiji used to say, you say that heaven, you dine with God, and heaven is eternal. So there, everything will be eternal. So perhaps, you know, we have to start somewhere so that some starter, some liquid or some soup is given. Now everything is eternal, so you'll be stuck with soup only. Because everything is eternal there, you know. And therefore, these funny ideas are there. So heaven description is there. And in most of the different, there, you will have 71 hur or something, you know. So hur they call it. And therefore, people are swarga paraha. And I tell you that passion for swarga doesn't go away so easily. Especially when you grow older and older. And if you read some book in that, you said, if you chant this every day 3 times, you will go to swarga. You are more likely to chant it. Even if you are studying Vedanta, as a backup, you can backup is what? In case this Vedanta does not give me Jivan Mukti, Videha Mukti, at least Swarga I will go. Gere to be high gere. So high means high, English high. High means thoda upper level. You know, you go flow, fall down, but somewhere at higher level. Swarga para, that bind is set is there. Everybody has got some concept of a beautiful place. How nice, you know, if I have a place where all around greenery is there and lot of sunlight is there, breeze is there, no pollution. All these people will have ideas. And that is swarga for you. So everybody is bound to some place, some setup. These people are Swarga Paraha. And such people are speaking this language. Yam imam pushpitam vacham pravadanti. These people are speaking pravadanti, first line. Speak vacham. Vacham means the speech, words. What type of words? Pushpitam, flowery language. Means language is very attractive. Like, you know, in some community, when they make simple thing, they will use big name. Like in Gujarat, some community is there. And in that, when they, yesterday's roti, they season it in this buttermilk. And the item they make, yesterday's roti, today they are seasoning. And you know what they call it? Chandrakala. So, what a nice nice name. What you are eating is a, what did you have? Chandrakala. Flowery language. But everything they will be using. Oh, in Swarga it is like this. In Swarga these people will be like this. Airavata will be there. Then this, the Kalpa Vruksha is there. All this. So, very flowery language they use. Some people are there. They use always, you know, big things. The small thing they don't talk. Pushpita Vacham. So this Pushpita, flowery language, which they speak, Taya, by that, some people's mind is overpowered. So here two sets of people are talked about. One set of people are confusing people. Other set of people are confused people. Misleading people, described by five adjectives. Misled people are described here by two adjectives. Bhogeshwarya prasaktanam taya paruta chetasa. Misleading people are described by avipashitaha, vedavadarataha, nanyadastidivadinaha, kamatmana, swargaparaha. Five adjectives. So misleading people naturally will have more adjectives. So they are misleading people. And misleading people use certain flowery language. And by that, these misled people are overpowered. Which is Swamiji used to use this expression. He says, Swayam confused, Anyan confusayati. So in Sanskrit, we have to use Nijanta Lakara. So they are confused and they will confuse others. And for such people who are overpowered by the language, flowery language, and that flowery language is described by some adjective. Kriya Vishesha Bahulam. This language, these words are full of specific activities. For this yaga, this karma. This yaga, that yaga. For that result, that yaga. So, Kriya Vishesha Bahulam. Full of many specific activities. For what purpose? Prati. For Bhogeshwarya Gatim. For the destination or the attainment of Bhoga and Aishwarya. They will say, if you do Avahanti Homa, you will get the Aishwaryam. If you do this Yaga, you will get the Indriya Samarthyam, Indriya Kama, Yajeta. So you will do this Yaga. If you do Jyotishtoma Yaga, you will get heaven. So they keep on talking about this specific activities meant for enjoyment and power. And that speech is Janma Karma Phala Pradam. The words are Pradam, literally means giving, leading to Janma Karma Phala. Bhashyakara says Janma Eva Karma Phala. The result of karma is what? Different Janma. You get different bodies. So those vakyas, those sentences are full of the description of various activities which will prompt you to do those activities and lead you to different bodies. So by such speech, the mind of certain people is overpowered. And for such people whose mind is overpowered by the speech full of karma and karma phala, in the mind of such people, in such mind, vyavasayatmika buddhihi na vidiyate. So in the mind of the people who are attached to the bhoga and aishwarya, and the mind, the people who are overpowered by the flowery speech of certain misleading people, in the mind of such people, vyavasayatmika buddhihi na vidhiyate. This well ascertained understanding of the karma yoga, jnana yoga does not take place. So in these three shlokas, some people are confused. Swamiji, where did you read all which words? So by the time we reach to find this word, we have gone to the next word. Anyway, this is how the shlokas are. See, they are confused, so their shlokas related to them also confused. Yakshan rupo balihi. So that's how it is. Alright. So here message is this much. When a person is overpowered by the flowery language regarding certain materialistic action and the result of such action, then in such mind, karma yoga and jnana yoga will not take place. Even though karma yoga is meant for chitta shuddhi, but even to start karma yoga, you require some chitta shuddhi. It's always like this. I always give this example. You start business for money, but for starting the business, you require some money. Unless you are very smart and you can you can manage the bank officers. So no problem. Otherwise it's difficult. You have to have some money. It is something like simple example. See, prayers are very fruitful. Prayers can bring some peace to your mind. But to have the desire for prayer, going for prayer, you require some peace of mind. You require some maturity. So prayers will give you maturity, but to do prayers you require maturity. Similarly, karma yoga will give chitta shuddhi, but for following karma yoga, to have the mind to follow karma yoga, you require some chitta shuddhi. If that also is not there, you are so ambitious and you want only material growth, then karma yoga is not possible. One qualification to become karma yogi is value for inner growth. I want to grow emotionally. I want to become more mature. If that is your commitment, then only karma yoga will appeal to you. Otherwise, karma yoga is not possible. And that idea was given in these three shlokas. Now, in the next shloka, Bhagavan is talking about the outlook and various qualities of a karma yogi. And that will help the person to know what it means to be a karma yogi. And that is given in the next shloka in the form of the suggestion by Bhagavan. Hey Arjuna, you become like this. If you want to be a successful karma yogi, be like this. And that is next shloka. Traigunya Vishaya Vedaha.
Traigunya Vishaya Vedaha.
Nistraigunyo
bhavarjuna
nirdvandvo nitya sattvastha niryoga kshema atmavan. It's a very important shloka in the context of karma yoga. So what all features are there for a karma yogi is very beautifully described. And firstly, it is said here that Vedas, especially Karma Kanda Rupa Vedas, are Traigunya Vishayaha. Vedas have got two parts, Karma Kanda and Jnana Kanda. This Karma Kanda part is called here Vedas. They are Traigunya Vishayaha. Here Traigunya refers to samsara. Traigunya means Trayanam Gunanam Samahara Traigunyam Samsaraha. So this Karma Kanda Vishayaha means dealing with. So Karma Kanda is dealing with Samsaraha. What does it mean? Various actions and the results of action which are part of Samsara. So if a person is following this content of Karma Kanda alone, and that too without proper attitude, then samsara guaranteed. संसारा है विल डेफिनेटली कंटिन्यू. पीपल सम पीपल आर अफ्रेड, स्वामी जी इफ आई अटेंड योर क्लासेस देन आई विल हैव वैराग्यम देन आई विल गेट मोक्षा. आई सेड दोज हु आर स्ट्रगलिंग आर नॉट गेटिंग. यू डोंट वॉन्ट एंड हाउ विल यू गेट इट, डोंट वरी. पीपल थिंक दैट इफ आई अटेंड क्लासेस देन आई विल लीव होम एंड ऑल. वी विल जनरली डोंट एनकरेज पीपल टू बिकम सन्यासी. We don't. Because we want people to be there so that we can get bhiksha. If everybody becomes sannyasi, who will give us bhiksha? So we generally don't be afraid that if people go to ashram, they become sannyasi. Some of them, they do become. There is no doubt about it. But our intention is not that. So you should become a sannyasi. In fact, I always tell this, that it is better to be a sincere grihastha than hypocrite sannyasi. It is better. We don't encourage that, you change, always we keep dress ready. In Shankaracharya movie, that they always show. The Shankaracharya is going, somebody comes, and the disciple has got dress ready. There you go, bas, sannyasi. We are not doing that. The message is that wherever you are, grow. If you are a grihastha, become a better grihastha. You are a father, become a better father. You are a wife, become a better wife. You are a husband, become a better husband. That is what you should remember. This Gita is taught by whom? Krishna. He is a sannyasi or a grihastha? Mahagrihastha. You people have only one wife. He had 60,008 wives. So he was a Mahagrihastha. Arjuna also what? Grihastha. He also had 3-4 wives, not one. So he had also wives. So he went for on pilgrimage. In pilgrimage, during pilgrimage, he had 2-3 wives. So he is also Grihastha. And this composed by Vedavyasa. Vedavyasa also is what? Grihastha. So we are not here to make anybody forcefully sannyasi. So sannyasa will not happen. So don't be afraid of this attending Vedanta classes. But yes, it will help you to grow. If you have got proper attitude towards action. If proper attitude towards action is not there, then samsara guaranteed. That's what he said, Traigunya Vishayaha Vedaha. So Vedas are dealing with the samsara, which includes karma and karma phala. Arjuna, do you want to remain in samsara forever? Arjuna must have said no. So Bhagavan said, if you don't want to remain in samsara, then what? Nistraigunyo bhava. Hey Arjuna, may you become Nistraigunya. Nistraigunya means free from three gunas. Now this word Nistraigunya is used for a wise person also. Otherwise called Gunatita. These three gunas are three components of the material cause for this world. Sattva guna, Rajoguna and Tamoguna. Sattva guna generally stands for happiness, peace, knowledge. Means happiness, peace and knowledge are the expression of sattva guna. Then desires, activities, ragadveshas they call it, all of them are expression of rajoguna. Sleepiness, laziness, lethargy, all of them are expression of tamoguna. And all three put together are called traigunyam. This traigunyam is being free from three gunas. And a wise person is the one who has discovered himself to be the self which is free from three gunas. Therefore, a wise person also can be called Nistraigunya. But here, it is not in that context because we are now studying the topic of Karma Yoga. Therefore, Nistraigunya here has got the meaning being free from these desires. Nishkamo bhava, be relatively free from materialistic desire. भाष्यकार से निस्त्रैगुण्यो भव मीन्स निष्कामो भव मीन्स स्लोली यू सी द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ दिस भोग एंड ऐश्वर्य सो दैट यू आउटग्रो द नीड फॉर दैट डोंट सप्रेस योर डिजायर प्रोसेस योर डिजायर सी वन स्वामीजी सेड वेरी नाइसली व्हेन वी हैव अ डिजायर एंड वी वॉन्ट टू बी फ्री फ्रॉम डिजायर देर आर टू वेज वन इज यू फुलफिल द डिजायर दैट ऑल्सो रिक्वायर सम एफर्ट और यू यूज सम विवेका एंड एनालाइज दैट वॉट आई वॉन्ट इज इट रियली रिक्वायर्ड और इट इज अ फैंसी इन द मोस्ट ऑफ अवर डिजायर आर फैंसीज ओनली एंड यू यूज योर टाइम टू डू विवेका एंड आउटग्रो दैट डिजायर And that is what is said here, Nistraigunyo Bhava, means may you be free from these desires which are caused by various gunas. And how will you become free from these three gunas? Nirdvandvaha. Be free from the pairs of opposite. What does it mean? Pairs of opposite means mana apamana. Sometimes you are honored, respected. Sometimes you are disrespected. You go there and people continue to watch TV. They did not even notice your presence. Or they were eating, they continue to eating. And bole beto beto, just sit. Didn't invite, okay, come or something. So you felt insulted. And some place you go, they got up and they did namaskara and all this. So they are called pairs of opposite. Some place manam is there, some place apamana is there. Sometimes there is heat, sometimes cold. And similarly, shita, ushna, sukha, dukha, pleasure is there, pain is there. All of them are called dvandvas, pairs of opposite. And any human life is bound to have these pairs of opposite. Can anybody say in this hall, that Swamiji, I have never seen any respect by anybody. Can anybody say that? Can anybody say that Swamiji, I am never disrespected by anybody? Can anybody say? So, disrespect also happens. Respect also happens in life. Similarly, can you say, Swamiji, I have never seen happiness? Many people say like this, but really it is a figurative. Can you say, Swamiji, I have never become happy in my life? You were happy. Some people, you know, somebody was troubling you, went away, that fellow went away for half an hour. You were happy. You know, some ladies are happy when husband go away for one tour. So happy. And sometimes they come back also, they are happy. Both ways happy. And dukkha also is there. Why is it so, you know? Because human life is caused by 50% of punya, 50% of papa. Therefore, you cannot avoid this pleasure and pain will be there. Even when you go to dining hall, some items you will like, some items you don't like. That will be there. This will be bound to be there. Everywhere it is like this. Nobody can give you all the time happiness. Nobody can give you all the time unhappiness also. Sometimes they give happiness, you know how? By going away, they give happiness. So they give happiness. And therefore, dvandva, the pairs of opposite, is a fact of life. Nirdvandva means you learn to develop this immunity to withstand the impact. They will be there. We cannot change the world, but we can learn to strengthen ourselves so the impact of them will be less. It is something like somebody is very thin, and if you just you know pat the person, then he will be shrunk. If you are fat and something happens, nothing. It will be only tickling. So you are strong. Then the external pairs of opposite will not affect you. If you are not strong, even a small change will affect you. Like some people, immunity is low. So temperature even 2 degrees change. They said, Swami, I got cold or I have this blister or something. In fact, they become thermometer for us. So we know. Temperature change ho gaya. So Bhagwan says, Nirdvandvo Bhava. How? By developing Viveka. Nitya Sattvastho Bhava. Sattva here stands for Viveka. So Nitya Sattvastho Bhava means, may you remain in Viveka all the time. And for that, Niryoga Kshemaha. Be free from the concern for attaining things and preserving things. Atmavan. May you become mindful, alert. More details we'll see in the next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamivashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi.